Welcome. My name is Michael Bender. I'm the editor of the online readings in Psychology and Culture. So that's the ORPC. The ORPC is an online open access journal of the ISECP, the International Association for Cross-Cultural Psychology. With me today is Thomas Talhelm, and I will ask him a couple of questions. But first, let me introduce him. Many of you might have already known him or gotten to know him in the online conference that we had in 2021. He is Associate Professor of Behavioral Science at the University of Chicago Booth School of Business. He has lived in China for quite some time and researches how historical rice and wheat farming in China helps us understand contemporary psychological differences and similarities. He recently wrote a review paper on the rice theory of culture for the online readings. For more details on him and his work, as well as the review article, of course, please see the video description below. Thomas, thanks for being here. Thank you for your time.
Yeah, glad to join.
Do you remember when you heard about the ORPC for the first time? When was that?
Yeah, I'm not sure the exact date, but it was, I think, last year. And my collaborator, Alex English, who I've worked with a lot over the years, mentioned the series. And so I started to look into it.
What do you think, in your personal experience, is special about the ORPC? I'm, of course, biased in asking it that way.
Yeah. I mean, one simple thing, I mean, there are definitely more and more open access journals out there these days, but that definitely helps, especially to get your work out there. And I kind of feel like this is more important for cultural psychologists because we're often talking to more international audiences, and scholars in other countries, I feel like, often have more difficulty accessing behind paywalls. Yeah. So that's definitely an issue. It's also great to have an outlet that understands culture. I mean, I had an article rejected the other day because it wasn't an experiment. And I thought, like, you know, somebody who like really hasn't thought a lot about culture. So to have a home where people kind of understand that, you know, culture, for example, is not something that you can always experiment with, is really great as an author.
How did you experience when you submitted the review process? So we sought you out after you gave the keynote at last year's conference to basically turn this into an online readings review. How did you experience that?
I thought the review process was kind of right in that sweet spot of sometimes reviews can be not detailed enough so that it's almost just like looks good and you don't really get much improvement out of it. And then there's the other extreme of people get so nitpicky that you make so many changes that it's not even really improved after all those changes. And I thought this was kind of like right in the sweet spot. I mean, people, the reviewers had clearly read the paper, which is nice, and it provided, you know, detailed feedback, but they seem to be also trying to be really constructive and, you know, productive and not nitpicky and not, you know, do this, do that. Like it was appropriately sort of big picture, small picture, and moving forward.
Big shout out to the reviewers. You know who you are. Is there something that you would recommend for future contributors? So for people like yourself that would contribute to the journal? So something that you wouldn't tell them?
Yeah. Tell them in terms of how to approach the journal and stuff like that? Or yeah. I would say reach out to the ORPC. I bet there are a lot of people out there who have research that would be perfect for it. And you guys can't contact everybody in the world. You don't know all the research that's out there. So I'm sure you guys would be interested in, you know, receiving more submissions. So I think there's a lot of people out there who have, you know, systems of, you know, series of research studies that would be perfect for like a sort of review, maybe challenging what's out there in the field. Yeah. One idea that I really like is how collectivism has sort of been idealized over the years, that that it's about like liking everybody or loving everybody, and it's like these harmonious relationships. And one of the things that I really like ideas out there is how it, you know, it's good and bad. There's good sides and there's bad sides to all sorts of like cultural approaches. So that'd be an idea that I've been really interested in lately and would love to see in the journal too.
Thanks for sharing. Is there something that you would like us, the editorial board, me as a stand-in here now, to think of or to maybe focus on more, or something that you would just like to mention?
Yeah, I was looking at the editorial board and I was wondering if we could get more like non-Western scholars on the board. Yes. I know. So when I was in undergrad, one of my advisors was Yuri Miyamoto, who just recently moved back to Japan. So I think she's great. Jing Hyung Na is in South Korea. I've always loved his classic paper on how cultural differences aren't always reducible to individual differences. So I really like that sort of theoretical perspective. And yeah, maybe scholars from South America or Africa, the Middle East. So yeah, that would be great to see. I'm sure the journal is open to that. So
absolutely. So that was one of the things that we actually wanted to address also in our recent hiring round. So last year we added three more people to the editorial board that actually bring in some diversity as well. But we're still looking for more people and to actually be more representative. So I think not only in terms of content, so what we cover in the journal, but also the people that we have working on this, we are concerned about including more underrepresented voices. So it's great that you bring that up. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for your time, Thomas. So this was just a little sneak peek. Check out his paper in the online readings. I hope this has been informative to viewers and also possible contributors and readers. And if you would like to know more about the ORPC, please do not hesitate to get in touch with us. We're easy to get in touch with. All relevant links are posted in the video description. Thanks again for your time, Thomas, and take care, everybody.
Yeah, thank you for having me.